Hello, July. So for this month, I really feel like the major theme that we are all going to be experiencing is how we perceive ourselves. And it's almost like this out of body experience, kind of like looking in, like from above, seeing like who we are, just everything about ourselves. I think a lot of us are going to be really vibing with that kind of introspection, this reflection period. And others I can see having a really hard, challenging time with this. Overall, the energy of July, it's not too crazy, nothing, you know, too alarming going on, but there are definitely themes that we need to be mindful of throughout the month of July. If this is your first time here, my name is Courtney, and this is my monthly Cosmic Energy Download series. I'm so excited to have you here because we're going to be breaking down the themes and energy of July. Really, the flow of this video, I love to talk about some astrology. I like to highlight some celestial moments that I think is really cool that I want you guys to be aware of. Go over, you know, some crystal recommendations that go along so well with this energy we're going to be experiencing. And then at the end of this video, I'd love to share some of my current crystal favorites and any fun life updates. So stay tuned to the end of the video to hear that. Alrighty guys, so for the flow of this video, I'm going to start off with some astrology highlights. I'm going to be going over the full moon in Capricorn, the new moon in Cancer, transitioning to Leo season, and the kicker on this list, Venus retrograde. Starting us off, we're going to be chatting about the full moon in Capricorn happening on July 3rd. Now, something that I want you guys to be mindful of during this full moon is to not overextend yourselves. And I really, really want you to listen to this. During this time, if you are noticing you are bottling up your emotions, maybe you've been holding on to kind of like telling the truth to someone, or there's been any kind of like energetic blockages in your body, this is the full moon to really release and let go of anything that has been weighing you down. This is a full moon where our mental health is going to be at the forefront. We really need to be mindful of our self-care. Now, the reason why we need to be mindful of this is because the sun will be in Cancer, right? It's Cancer season, and we're going to be having this full moon in Capricorn. Personally, my nodes, my north node and my north node's in Capricorn and my south node is in Cancer. So I know this energy very, very well. It really is a reminder to nurture ourselves, to make sure that we are okay mentally, physically, you know, in all aspects, we're feeling good so that we aren't running amok or putting so much focus and energy on this one thing that maybe isn't giving us this return that we truly desire. You know, we have to make sure we're taking care of ourselves, we're feeling good so that we can keep serving others and keep, you know, working on those things that light us up. Capricorn is very much a workaholic. They love doing things, producing things. And it's so important to make sure that we are taking care of ourselves before we can really take care of others. So some crystals that I really recommend working with during the full moon in Capricorn would be lepidolite. This is great for really giving us a lot of relief, especially anxiety relief. If you feel like you are just bottling up so much and you need a release, I definitely recommend working with lepidolite. I also recommend working with blue chalcedony or blue calcite. These are really calming crystals and they really help us just emotionally feel balanced. So if you are kind of feeling, you know, a little bit hectic during this time, working with these crystals will really soothe your soul. Next up, we have the new moon in Cancer, which is happening on July 17th. This new moon is going to be like the last push of like Cancer vibes, of Cancer energy. We're really going to be feeling this Cancerian, you know, loving, nurturing energy on this new moon. It's good to be mindful that, you know, 5 days after this new moon, we are going to start Venus retrograde. So this new moon is really a great opportunity to hold the vision of yourself, you know, embrace your divine feminine, set intentions where you are calling in confidence, where you are calling in self-growth, you know, really investing in yourself and finding that love and stability to carry out throughout this entire, you know, season of Venus retrograde. Cancer moons are always great to do any kind of water ritual or taking a ritual bath. I definitely recommend doing that. I personally love to drink, crystal elixirs. So this would be a really powerful new moon to, set out your water with some crystals in it, have the new moon, charge it up and drink that water, the next couple days while you're embracing, your new intentions that you've set. I think that's a really fun ritual idea. Some crystals that I definitely recommend working with on the new moon in Cancer would be aquamarine. It's like the water stone. It's great for release, for letting go, a very like calming energy along with the other crystal suggestions I've mentioned. I also really, really recommend working with black moonstone. Black moonstone is the perfect moonstone crystal to work with during the new moon phase. It really is all about like a new beginning, setting intentions. It matches so well with Cancer energy. So I definitely recommend having black moonstone with you when you're doing any kind of new moon ritual, and just really take it easy, take it easy on this new moon. Sometimes some of us can be a little bit more hyper or kind of like irritated during a new moon rather than a full moon. Everyone's energy is different. So if you are feeling kind of like this pent up energy, really embrace that water element. Go outside, go to the beach, or if that's not possible, take that bath. Really connect with water during this new moon. And the last celestial moments I really wanted to highlight are happening on July 22nd. There's two things happening. We are entering into Leo season on July 22nd, and we are also entering into Venus retrograde. So I'd love to talk about Leo season first. So around this time, I've noticed for years when we transition from Cancer season to Leo season, there is such an energetic shift with that. And I have always noticed it because it's kind of like we are so at home. We're feeling so comfy, cozy. It's kind of like we're in bed and we're just, so content and loving life. We just feel good. And then all of a sudden we wake up and we feel like we are just in the middle of this hustle and bustle, like a million things are going on and you're like, what is happening? It feels like you've been just thrown out of bed and like tossed on the street and like in a busy city, like, come on, let's go, get up and go. Leo season is literally such an extraordinary time to just be alive. I love Leo season. I love that fire energy, but it is so jarring coming from Cancer season to Leo season. So I just wanted to note, during this week, that we are transitioning to Leo season, like just be mindful that things are going to start to pick up in your life. And this happens year after year. I always notice this. So just be mindful of that. Another reason why I love Leo season is that in Leo season, we have Lionsgate, which I made a whole video on Lionsgate last year. If you want to check that out, I'll definitely have a pop-up card show up right now. I love Lionsgate, and I most definitely will be talking about it again in our August monthly download. So check back in there then to hear, how we're going to be experiencing Lionsgate and the magical goodness that Lionsgate brings. And last but not least, let's now touch on Venus retrograde. So in my June report, I kind of gave you a taste of, what Venus retrograde in Leo is going to be feeling like for all of us. I'll do a little bit of a recap. So, Venus, the planet of beauty, love, money, when it goes retrograde, it's kind of like we have these rose-colored glasses on. We kind of, want to be mindful with the decisions we're making in those realms, this Venus energy, because most of the time we will be like, what was I thinking? Why did I decide to do that? Because we're going to possibly regret it, later when Venus isn't retrograde. And when we think about Leo, Leo energy, Leo is such a courageous, brave, craves attention, loves the spotlight. It's very much like, look at me energy, right? So when we have Venus in retrograde, I feel like most of us will be really criticizing the way we look during this time. Again, we have those rose-colored glasses on. It's suggested, really not to change our physical appearance during Venus retrograde. And I would say most definitely, if Venus is in Leo, that's even more indicator to just really pause on doing any kind of, changes with the way you look, the design of things, your home, don't make really big investment purchases that you may regret later. And unfortunately, I feel like this Venus retrograde is going to be going on for quite some time. So Venus goes direct on September 4th, although we will have a post shadow until October 6th. So it's kind of like between September and October, we're kind of weaning off that rose-colored glasses. You know, it's better to make decisions around that time than right in the middle, you know, of July. You know, we're going to be in the thick of it. We're really going to be feeling it. So I just wanted to throw that out there. I've noticed over the years during a Venus retrograde, it can kind of affect people in two different ways. There's the type of person that really is not liking their reflection. They are feeling super self-critical. They're not really gelling with how the way they are perceiving ourselves, or just everything kind of feels a little wonky for them. The other type of person is totally like obsessed with themselves. Like they love the way they look. They're feeling extra confident. So be mindful. You might be one of those types of people during this time. You're either going to be very self-conscious or you're going to be like very extra during this Venus retrograde in Leo. Some crystals that I recommend working with during Venus retrograde, and I'll get into Leo season two. I mentioned these in my last video, but pink tourmaline is great for any heart-centered, you know, things that may be going on during this retrograde. You know, if we're feeling self-critical or we're feeling kind of down on ourselves, pink tourmaline, it's great for that. Kind of like speaking affirmations, you know, hold your pink tourmaline when you're doing them. I also really, really recommend rhodochrosite. Rhodochrosite is like the perfect stone to help bring in self-confidence. It's great for people that kind of have this innate feeling of feeling like they always like don't look good. It helps with like boosting your self-confidence, for discovering and seeing your inner beauty, to know that you are unique and gorgeous and you don't need a, you know, self-negative talk about yourself. Rhodochrosite is wonderful for that. And then I also really recommend working with rose quartz. You know, the stone of love, it's great to work with during Leo season and also during this retrograde. So really think, you know, heart chakra crystals during this time. Alrighty, so that is all of the astrological highlights I really wanted to share with you in July. Nothing too crazy, you know. I would say, you know, the main component here is that Venus retrograde having us kind of like kind of second guess, you know, ourselves or just the way we look. So it's good to be mindful about that. I'd love to now share with you some crystals that I've really been vibing with the last month. And the first one that I'd love to share with you is this really beautiful bumblebee jasper. So I will say, you know, I've been mainly working with bumblebee jasper with my crystal gridding. You know, the last month and a half I've had bumblebee jasper in my crystal grid, activated in my home. I also had this bumblebee jasper in my bedroom. I really wanted to bring about this fun energy during like Gemini season, and it kind of transferred over into like Cancer season. I really wanted to feel like less stress and like really be living in the moment. Bumblebee jasper is a crystal that really brings out your inner child. It brings this like innocence and kind of like this really good euphoric feeling. You know, I've been planning my wedding the past, you know, few months, and it can be a little serious or just a little bit kind of like draining to like think about all these things. And I wanted to remember to have fun with it, you know. I want to enjoy this time, and even though it can be stressful, I really wanted to have, you know, this childlike energy of just being so happy with where I'm at in life, with every aspect of my life. And I really feel like bumblebee jasper, the yellowness, you know, this beautiful like energy just beams from it. You know, it really activates our solar plexus chakra. It makes us happy. And I feel like it brought a lot of goodness in my life for the past like month and a half while my grid has been activated in my home. So this next crystal that I've been obsessed with is actually a beauty tool that I've been using a lot lately. And that is this agate gosha. So I actually did a video on like how to do like facial massages with goshas. I'm probably saying it wrong. I think it's gua sha. I always say gosha, whatever. This is from this amazing brand called Ember Wellness. And I got this, I think I got it for Christmas actually. Got it a couple months ago, and I have been really like consistently doing this on my face, kind of like doing lymphatic drainage. I feel like as I'm getting closer to like my wedding, I want to like do all the beauty like things. So I've been really practicing and doing my gua sha, like, almost, I don't want to like say I'm doing it every day, but I want to say I'm doing it at least 4 times a week. The main areas that I'm focusing on are my chin and my jawline, kind of like my lower face. And I just feel like I'm obsessed with it. Like, I haven't really consistently done it until now. And now I feel like I want to do it every day and I love it. And, you know, I'm also, you know, being more active. I want to try to look my best for my wedding day. So I feel like the mixture of like me, you know, eating healthy, exercising, and also doing my gua sha, I feel like I'm feeling more confident. And I would love to like see if it does a difference on my face. I'll definitely tell you guys if it does. But this is like a fun crystal practice I've been doing and I've been loving so much. So let me know if you like do any kind of like crystal beauty, like skincare routines in the comments. I'd love to hear any tips that anyone may have out there, but I'm really loving doing my gua sha. Alrighty guys, I have one more crystal that I have been obsessed with that I wanted to share with you. I actually talked about this in my crystal shapes part 3 video, and that is working with this amazing clear quartz skull. This is the first time I've ever worked with a skull shape before, and I know like skulls in general can be like a little intimidating. It kind of seems like maybe like gothic or kind of like darker, but personally, how I've been working with the skull shape is really connecting with my ancestors, connecting with my angels, and really getting divine wisdom from them. The skull shape really connects to our crown chakra. You know, it boosts our kind of like mental enhancement, feeling like we are getting downloads, opening up our crown chakra to spiritual guidance. It's like a really cool you know, practice to do with a skull shape. Over the past month, I feel like since I have kind of set the intention that I want to connect more with my angels and, you know, my ancestors, I've been feeling like a lot of like kind of like a loving presence around me. When I go outside, I feel like I'm seeing a lot of black feathers, which when you see a black feather, it symbolizes protection. So I feel like my angels are telling me that they're protecting me. I did a ritual not too long ago with a purple candle to like honor my spiritual development and, you know, where I'm at in my spiritual journey. And I really felt their presence when I was, you know, actively, you know, connecting with them. If you're someone that is interested in diving into ancestral work, you know, ancestral karma, I feel like working with a skull shape is perfect for that. But yeah, I just wanted to come on here, and if anyone out there is kind of like doesn't really know if they feel like they want to get a skull or they feel like intimidated by it, I just want to let you know, like, it doesn't have to be like this scary thing. Like, it can be like a fun, you know, experience that you have. It's up to you with how you want to do your crystal practice. It can be whatever you want it to be. So don't feel intimidated by the look of something. You know, dive in, do some research, learn about something new, and it may surprise you because you may be feeling really drawn to work with that thing. Alrighty guys, so that is it for today's video. I hope that you enjoyed learning about July's energy, you know, all the astrological goodness that is coming our way and things to be mindful of, but nothing too crazy, right? I feel like it's going to be a good month. I hope you enjoyed hearing, you know, my current crystal practices and what crystals I'm vibing with. I would love for you to comment down below what crystal you have been really drawn to lately. I haven't asked you guys this, so I'm super interested, like, what crystal has been calling to you lately. Please let me know down in the comments. If you liked today's video, please give it a big thumbs up. If you are new here, I would love it if you subscribed. Thanks so much for hanging out, and I'm wishing you a very happy July.